When I'm evaluating a patient with atrial fibrillation, first, I want to understand what type of AFib they have. Is it paroxysmal, persistent, long-standing, persistent, or permanent? We then want to look at their lifestyle and other conditions that may impact the atrial fibrillation itself or the progression of the disease. And next, and more important, focus on what is their risk of stroke and how can we reduce it? And finally, how can we improve your quality of life? If you have atrial fibrillation and it's affecting your quality of life, your ability to exercise, or causing significant symptoms that are impairing your life, your day-to-day activities, there are lots of treatment options. For patients with atrial fibrillation, we can either consider what's called a rate control strategy, which that means you will remain in atrial fibrillation, and medications will be used to slow down your heart, such as beta blockers or calcium channel blockers. And for almost all patients, at least a trial of rhythm control is indicated. With rhythm control, the goal is to maintain your heart in normal rhythm, to use medications or procedures to try to keep the patient in sinus rhythm, which is the normal rhythm of the heart.